Alaska Live TV. Music and conversation from the KUAC FM studio is made possible by a grant from Design Alaska. Architecture and engineering for the new frontier.
Jasper String Quartet, welcome back to Fairbanks and the KUAC studios.
Thank you so much. It's wonderful to be here.
And Sam Quintel, and welcome back to your hometown, too.
Like I said, it's wonderful to be here.
Nice.
Start us off with a movement from a piece that you might be playing tonight, or tomorrow night, I mean.
Yeah, this is the first movement of a Beethoven quartet, Opus 18, number 3.
Thank you.
Jasper String Quartet here in the KUAC studios for Alaska Live. I'm your host, Lori Neufeld. Can you introduce the Jasper String Quartet, Sampras?
Absolutely. I am Sam Quintel, originally from here, and I play the viola. On cello, we have Rachel Henderson, and she's originally from Ann Arbor, Michigan. Our first violinist is Jay Frivogel, and he's originally from St. Louis, Missouri. And our second violinist is Sai Chonobayashi, and she is originally from Tokyo, Japan. And we all live now in New Haven, Connecticut.
Well, thank you for making your way back up to Alaska. That piece that you play it with such fire and emotion. That's being in here in the room, it's just it's a really charged atmosphere. And I'm sure your audiences feel that too when you play.
Well, there's really something special about that piece because it's actually the first piece that the first string quartet Beethoven ever wrote. And he went on to really evolve the genre in ways that everybody has been trying to live up to since then. So we feel really fortunate that we get to, you know, start with the first piece he wrote. It's Opus 18, number 3, but it's actually the first one he wrote. It just was published in the middle of his opening set of quartets. But we really love Beethoven as we love all of the composers we're playing, but there's really something special about him, I think.
How interesting. So it should have been number 1, but the way it was published, it ended up being number 3.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, Beethoven and his publishers were looking to make a good amount of money as well, you know. So they were. It's similar to how you might think of publishing a movie or publishing a book. You don't always necessarily put what you first write. You don't necessarily put it first. And I think he felt that that wasn't exactly how he wanted to open with his set of 6. It's number 3, and it's incredible. So as well as number 1, 2, 4, 5, and 6. So,
do we know what was happening in Beethoven's life at that point? Because he poured in a lot of emotion into that piece, obviously.
Well, he wrote that when it was in his younger life, and I think he had maybe started to realize that he was starting to go deaf, but it certainly wasn't a big thing in his life. So it's got a very youthful atmosphere to it, and a very, I mean, all the Opus 18s have an innocence, and definitely they're very much based in Haydn's quartets and Mozart's quartets.
It doesn't have that sadness yet where he was slipping
into
deafness.
And they're also very much in the classical style, whereas later in his life he started to move out of that and really push the boundaries a bit more. So these are sort of his demonstration of his mastery of the classical style.
Oh, the Jasper Quartet, you are such educators too, which is great. You know, you've done quite a few residencies at different places.
Yeah, that's right. We're actually the Quartet in Residence at Oberlin Conservatory. That's for next year, and this past year was our first year. And we have we finished up a 2-year residency this year with the Caramore Center in Katona, New York.
With several high schools?
Yes, we went to maybe 2 or 3 high schools every day, or maybe 1 sometimes, worked with the students there and performed for them and let them ask about our life.
Is there a kid that you just remember that you're like, oh man, we saw that spark?
Actually, we just got a Facebook message from a violist at one of the schools that we played at,
Jemin,
and he invited us to their orchestra concert, and it was really sweet. We were really touched.
That's great. And what, he played viola?
Yeah.
It was this great thing that he and Sam had this wonderful connection. But and part of it was that he was playing in his school orchestra, actually a very good school orchestra, but he was the only violist. So it was amazing because he really took it upon himself to be a viola section, you know. So he and Sam were just, you know, they had such a great time when they were playing together when we played with their orchestra.
Because, Sam, you had to take on the viola, because you were originally a violinist, right?
That's right.
You had to take on the viola for this quartet.
I really love playing viola in string quartets. I think I like being in the middle of things. I was never really a first violinist type of personality. And so when it came time to play in this quartet, In addition to that, I'm also very tall, so the other members were like, you're pretty big, and the violin looks kind of silly when you play it. Maybe you should play viola.
That's right.
This is Jay. I mean, there's something very, in a quartet, we get asked this often. They say, you know, who is your leader or who is in charge? And the great thing about a quartet is that it is a completely democratic ensemble. So, yes, as a first violinist, sometimes I do play more tunes, especially in like sort of the early Beethoven or the Haydn quartets. But everybody's part in a string quartet is just as important as the next one. If the middle of the sound isn't working together and playing and with the absolute artistry, it affects everybody's sound. So that's one of the best parts of playing chamber music and playing in a quartet is everybody is so important.
Makes me excited to hear the next piece to see how you do that. What's the next on the program today?
Well, my favorite movement from Beethoven again, and Opus 18, number 3, last movement. And the things I was just thinking the other day when we are in Juno, that this movement is really a lot of fun and starts off by violin duet and a row of two voices, you know, chase after us. And it's like it's a little bit describes like our personality as a group because there's a joke, a lot of jokes in the movement. And in the middle, there's a little bit of argument. But it's never get really too serious. And then at the end, like a lot of celebration. So I just love this piece, like the nature of this piece. So I hope you also enjoyed all
the
listeners.
So the viola and the cello kind of chase the violins down at times. Do you get to chase them? Oh, good. It's a back and forth.
Yep.
And one more time, what is it that you're playing?
Beethoven, Opus 18, number 3. And this is the fourth movement, the presto.
Thank you.
Member of the Jasper String Quartet chose that one for performance. That's just beautiful and moving. And it's wonderful that, you know, we heard your program last year and it was had such a wide variety too, and this year you've come back with another program that has such a variety of like the classical style mm-hmm. from the classical period mm-hmm. and some newer music, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're playing the second movement out of a quartet by Aaron Jay Kernis, and the second movement is really kind of the emotional heart of this piece, and we feel it really stands well on its own. But this is as a composer and that we've really sort of fallen in love with over the past year. We played.
He's still living, right?
Yeah,
he lives in
New York. We've met him. We've worked with him. He's a wonderful, wonderful man. Very elegant and soft spoken, but very, very thoughtful. And so we've got to work with him and really kind of delve into his music. And we really feel like our quartet has a connection with his music. It's this piece especially is kind of backward looking in its techniques. He uses a lot of more tonal things. He quotes from Beethoven kind of throughout. There's a beautiful chorale in the part that we're going to play for you that's kind of taken out of Beethoven and then modified slightly in his own special way. So it's music that we really feel connected to and passionate about. And it's actually on our first CD, which is going to be coming out in the fall, probably in October.
Congratulations. I'm glad to hear that.
It's long overdue, but it's finally going to be here.
So this Aaron
Jay Kernis.
Aaron Jay Kernis.
Yeah, right.
And I think that's a great connection that you've made, that you've chosen to seek out a composer that's still alive, still composing.
Right.
And maybe he'll compose something specifically for you someday.
We are actually in the process of commissioning a string quartet from him, so we're hoping that his third string quartet will be written for us.
I'm very glad to hear that, too, and then that'll just be on the second CD. And
exactly.
You'll come back and you'll perform that for us, too.
We certainly hope so.
So we'll play this. We're going to play an excerpt from this movement. The entire work is 40 minutes long, and we'll play maybe, I think it's about maybe 5 minutes of it, and it hopefully will give you a really good sense of where this piece is going and why we love it so much.
Thank you.
Well, I really didn't want that to end. That was just, oh, the way the strings cascade around, too. I don't quite know the words to use for that, but
I think cascade is right.
It's just so interesting, and yes, that definitely made me want more of that one. I think partly because it is so new. I've never heard that before.
Right. Yeah, that, you know, that I'm glad you mentioned that, because that's something that why we love his music and why we love this piece specifically. It is new. It is something that we are able to put our stamp on, but there is an emotional depth to it. You know, there's a you really get something from playing it, and you get something from listening to it, whether it's the first time or whether it's, you know, now we've probably played this movement well over 20 times in performance, and that's the mark of a great piece, is one that as you play it more, you find more and more in it. And so I think that emotional depth is really something important about his music, why we love Aaron Jay Kernis's music.
Yeah. And I can see it in your body language and in your faces that it creates an emotion for you, and that you are still really in love with this piece. Yeah.
Definitely.
And that piece in its entirety will be on your new CD that's coming out?
That's right, along with a piece by Beethoven.
Jasper String Quartet, thank you for coming in today and making classical music so exciting and so accessible. I think your knowledge of it and just the way you play makes it just that much more fun.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Yeah,
thanks for having us.
Alaska Live TV, music and conversation from the KUAC FM studio, is made possible by a grant from Design Alaska, architecture and engineering for the new frontier.